Today I got a really simple distinction that it is really, really powerful nonetheless, and that is the distinction between what I know and what I live. Oftentimes we have these ideas that if I get more knowledge, if I read more books, you know, in fact, what a lot of people say, oh, you know, CEOs live 52 or read 52 books a year. They're probably also living those 52 books a year, or at least some little nugget from each one. And that's what I challenge you to do is, if you're going to go and read something, if you're going to expand your knowledge, then make it something that you live. I've heard this said before, is the real journey in life is the 18-inch drop, the drop from something that you know to your heart. And when I hear that, what that means to me is when it comes into your heart, it's something that you embody, it's something that you live. So take that knowledge that you have and figure out how is it that you can live it. Put it into your life. If that means putting it into your calendar, if that means making a checklist for your day, if that means having an environment that enhances doing whatever that is. Does that mean putting your running shoes right near the end of your bed? It's not about what you know, it's about what you live. That's what changes your life.